The story of an evil who has been locked up for more than 10 million years. He has beaten the strongest gods. He has beaten the strongest mortals that we know of. But how can you beat him? How can you go one step beyond the doubts and the fears that you had? To beat someone that couldn't be defeated. Someone who might end everything that you love. This someone is Moro. He is specially strong sense. He's not using ki or brute strength. He's using something that the Saiyans have almost never encountered, and that's magic. They're not used to that. So how can they defeat him? If I'm gonna be honest, the only way that I can see them winning this fight is if Goku somehow used mastered Ultra Instinct. Since this guy just absorbs and absorbs, the Spirit Bomb won't be enough. Super Saiyan Blue wasn't enough. So what now? He gets your energy the more you fight. So in my opinion, the only way for them to win is for Goku to use Ultra Instinct. And soon enough, you will know why I'm saying this. This is chapter 49 of the Dragon Ball Super manga. In the last chapter, we saw Moro making two wishes. The first wish was for him to get all of his magic back. But the second wish we didn't see. A wish that might make him superior to everyone else. A wish that is a means to an end. We wanted to know what he wished for. Did he wish to become an immortal? Did he wish to never be sealed again? Or was it something else? We ended the last chapter with the Lord of Lords restoring Goku and Vegeta's energy back. That's where we left things. Now we continue our story. We see that Moro is absorbing the life energy of planet Namek. He's getting the power of everything that he can. We see that Moro isn't just absorbing the life energy of the planet itself, but the life energy of everyone on the planet, of Meros, the Namekian, and Jakku. When they see what's happening, they get off the planet. The only Namekian that survived is this kid. He says that the Great Elder named him his successor. He must have foresaw what will happen, and now it's his responsibility to survive. Mir says that they want to build Namek, and I'm actually with them. Namek, since the beginning of Dragon Ball, has been met with many crises. Now, this is just adding to it, and they deserve their share of peace. As they're flying through space, we see energy all around them. Then it zooms to Moro creating a giant energy ball. We see his sinister look. He's gathering all of the energy from planet Namek. Even though he got his power back, he still wants more. From behind him, Goku, Vegeta, and the Lord of Lords teleport. They are in their Super Saiyan Blue form. They rush towards him to take him out, but he just smiles. Then, as they attack him, their attacks go through him. Something is off about him, but they give it another shot and go once more at him. Now they fire ki blasts. Then Goku teleports on top of him and strikes him, but the attack once more goes through him. Something is off about him, as they say. And the Lord of Lords says his real body isn't here. He's absorbing the planet's energy from somewhere else. As they look behind them, they spot him standing on a rock, absorbing the energy of the planet. Goku doesn't think twice. He goes at Moro. Vegeta yells at him to wait. Saiyans can't survive in the vacuum of space. They will leave things for the Lord of Lords. As he rushes towards him, as he gets close to him, Moro calls for the energy that he gathered. When he takes it, he eats it. Then the Lord of Lords strikes him on his face, but he was 1 second too late. Nothing happens to Moro from the attack. He grabs his hand and says, "You dare wear that face in my presence." The Lord of Lords tries to attack him once more, but Moro dodges. Then every attack from it doesn't work on him. He blocks every attack. He teleports on top of the Lord of Lords, striking him down. Goku and Vegeta are just there watching. They can't do anything, even though they want to do something, but they can't. Some good news is that Namek isn't losing energy anymore. Since Moro is busy fighting the Lord of Lords, they have left Namek's orbit. Goku and Vegeta are still there, so Meros is headed towards them. We continue the fight. As the Lord of Lords rushes once more at Moro, he fires ki blasts at him, but Moro dodges every single one of them. He gathers more energy and fires it towards him. Moro just stands there. The Lord of Lords figured out what dumb move that was. So what happens is, and what the Lord of Lords realized was, Moro can absorb energy. So he absorbs the attack. Then he goes at him. He knows that he has gotten him. He hit bumps him. He punches him so hard, he sends him crashing. Moro tells him that his strange abilities confused him. But now, since his power exceeds his, they no longer trouble him. Did something happen those past 10 million years? Because this is unimpressive. He's right about that. This is not the Lord of Lords from 10 million years ago. This is Pooh that absorbed him. But what's different about him? Why isn't he as strong as before? He gets up and says to Moro that he's going to come quietly back to the Galactic Patrol prison. If he resists, they will seal off his magic once more. Even though he said that, Moro before was scared of that technique. But now, something is different. He's not that scared. He says, the old sealing technique? Go ahead, do your worst. He's not fazed, he's not scared, he's actually happy as it seems. But why though? As he explains, he doesn't sense the same god power that he once sensed from the Lord of Lords. He dares to say that he lacks the power to unleash the sealing spell. As we see from the Lord of Lords' face, he is right. So this is why he wasn't scared. It wasn't that the third wish is for him to not be sealed once more. He knows that he can't be sealed because now he's stronger than the Lord of Lords, and he himself doesn't even have the power to seal him. So what is the third wish if it wasn't for him to not be sealed again? As Goku and Vegeta are watching the fight, they sensed that Moro has gotten stronger. And if he gets more strong than he is now, they won't be able to beat him. From behind them, the Galactic Patrol ship is there. They get on it and leave. On the ship, Goku doesn't know what's going on. Does Moro need to be held in place to use the technique? But what we feared for, what we don't wanna happen, happens. As Mirrors explain, it's not that Moro needs to be held in place. It's the fact that the Lord of Lords can't use that technique. It occurred to him when Pooh attempted to use it. It was the race in the hole, but now it isn't anymore. As he says, he can't use it because of the splitting that Pooh underwent. The split between the good and evil halves. If you didn't know and you didn't watch Dragon Ball Z, Pooh was the mix between good and evil. Back in Dragon Ball Z, it split and evil Pooh stayed. That was Kid Pooh back then. And Fat Pooh is the good half. As Mirror says, the god power that the Lord of Lords had was passed to evil Pooh. Because the good Pooh inherited the great Lord of Lords physical appearance, he assumed that he also received the god power as well. But maybe that power went to evil Pooh instead. Evil Pooh, the one that Goku and Vegeta fought back at the end of Dragon Ball Z, had actual god power. So the first god that they have actually fought, someone who had god power, was evil Pooh. As we get back to the fight, the Lord of Lords is losing it. As Moro strikes him, he's hurting. He teleports behind him and fires a giant ki blast. The Lord of Lords teleport behind him and tries to land an attack, but Moro blocks it and says, did someone steal your power and reduce you to that pink form from before? As he says that, he kicks him so hard, he sends him flying, crashing to everything in his way. When he crashes, he gets up. He's seeing something. He's seeing Goku and evil Pooh. At the moment when Goku had the spirit bomb, he's seen the end of the fight. The end when Goku has managed to beat evil Pooh. He realizes what actually happened. When Goku won against Pooh, the Lord of Lords lost his power. But those memories isn't just for the Lord of Lords. Moro has actually seen them. Now it's clear to him that no one in the universe has the power to seal his magic. And how wonderful is that? To have no fear from being sealed again. Vegeta now says something that actually was the solution from the beginning. He says that gimmicky techniques like that never get the job done. It's always going to take brute force to bring down this foe. Goku actually agrees with him. Now this is why I'm saying it's not about the technique, it's about the power that you have. This is why I'm saying Goku needs to go beyond his limit to Ultra Instinct. That's why I said it at the beginning. They have gotten to where the Lord of Lords and Moro are, but they can't do anything here. As they see what's going on, Mirrors calls from the bottom. He says, can you assure me that you two are more powerful than Moro? They say, magic aside, we are stronger. Just one of us in his Super Saiyan Blue form could handle him. and I'm not sure about that, since they're putting magic aside. But what if they don't put that aside? We saw back then how he has beaten Vegeta and Goku at Planet Namek. So what's different now? They need something else. It's not about Super Saiyan Blue. It's not about Super Saiyan God. He will absorb their energy, and now he's stronger than before. They need something to get the job done as quick as possible. So now, after he hears that, he will drag Moro back to Planet Namek, where the two of them can finish the job. He gets out of the ship and goes there, as Moro gathers energy and is ready to finish the Lord of Lords. As he's about to send the attack, Mirrors is behind him. He gets him on his hand from the whip that he used before, but Moro just grabs it and throws Mirrors back to the Lord of Lords. He gets him and flies away. He tells him that they need to get him back to Namek, where they can win against him. He asks if he can use the teleportation technique, and from the power that he still has, he can. As they're talking, Moro is there. Mirrors fires at him. What is he planning to do? Those won't work against him, and even Moro tells him that. But he just fires more and more, and Moro just evades them with ease. He had enough. He attacks him with an energy attack. Mirrors dodges it and fires a whip at a rock behind him. As he destroys it, Mirrors gets on top of him and uses the boosters on Moro's face. He gets him in his eyes. Then the Lord of Lords grabs him from behind. Now he has gotten him. He teleports him to Namek. As Goku and Vegeta sense that Moro is back on Namek, they use instant transmission and teleport there. They see them. Goku says, "Moro, ready for a fair fight. We are at full power now, so you won't get away this time." Moro just looks and smiles as they're standing there in the wasteland of Namek. Moro is just looking and smiling. He's not afraid from them. He says, "Oh, Planet Namek still holds energy. What a waste to leave food on my plate." He's not worried about what Goku said. He's just standing there as nothing is happening, as those two aren't a match for him. But as Vegeta said, in their Super Saiyan Blue form, they can take him on. But he doesn't think that. Why isn't he afraid? Why is he ignoring them? Vegeta tells him what we are all thinking of. He doesn't comprehend the situation. They're about to destroy him once and for all. This is what they're supposed to do now. Moro just looks at him. He laughs and says, "So foolish, so naive. You seem to have forgotten something quite important." They're in shock. What is he talking about? He says, "The third wish." Now he has done it. As I said before, his wish is a means to an end. He's so confident in that last wish. He doesn't think those two can beat him. So what is his last wish? From what he's saying is, and what I think is, he wished to become an immortal. Not in the sense of age, but in the sense of his body. No matter what he takes, they can't beat him. He will just regenerate. I'm saying this because it will give him time in the fight. Time to absorb energy, to get stronger in the fight and make your opponent weak. And what better way to do that than become an immortal, so that the fight will drag on for more time. That's what I think Moro wished for. That's why, even though in their Super Saiyan Blue form they're stronger than him, but they can't beat him. The fight will drag on to a point where he absorbs all of their energy and he wins the fight. That's why I think he's so confident in his last wish. And this is where we end chapter 49 of the Dragon Ball Super manga. The story of how Moro will awaken a new Goku. Thank you for watching, and saying that, I will see you on the next one. Bye bye.